The next tab is the Facilities tab. Go to the left and select the Facilities tab. On this tab, you can change the building name. We will call this Rural Fire Station. Next, you can see there are measures tags, just like we discussed previously, that energy efficiency measures can use as keywords to change parameters of the model. That's for advanced energy modeling. Next, you can see the north axis is set at 0. Going back to the Geometry tab, we can see that the north axis is currently set on this green axis line. If we wanted to orient the building such that the north axis was on the red axis line, we would have to adjust this by 90 degrees. Going back to the Facility tab, you can change this to 90 degrees. Next, you will see that there are three different defaults that you can add from your libraries. This is the power of OpenStudio. OpenStudio fills in information from a top-down approach, child-parent relationship. This is the very top. At the very top, you can fill in space types, construction sets, and schedule sets. I went through and deleted some of the information in our file to just illustrate this example to you. Let's go to spaces. You can see in the spaces that we have, I have removed some of the information. Space type for the apparatus bay is not there. Likewise, the default construction set and the default schedule set is not there. If we go back to the Facility tab and add those into the top, all of that information will be defaulted to these default values. Go to My Model tab, Space Types. We will say the default space type is an apparatus bay. Construction sets, we only have one, metal fire station. And schedule sets, we'll just use the default fire station schedule set. Going back to the spaces, you will note that the space type for the apparatus bay has been populated, but the default construction set and schedule set have not been populated. That's because all of these are empty, and they will key on to the defaults for the facility. These are the ones that we just dropped into this space right here, these spaces. Let's go to the Stories tab. Here is where you can add additional stories to your building. If you haven't already done those using FloorSpace.js or some other different geometry editor. Let's go to the Shading tab. Shading tab is also used for adding additional geometry to your model that is not actually within the building or does not affect or does not create exterior loads such as lights or exterior equipment. You could think of shading as adjacent buildings and trees that shade the building throughout the day that and would reduce cooling loads. We will not be using this for this model. We will do shading in a more advanced lesson. Let's go to exterior equipment. Here is where you can add exterior lighting to your building. Let's say we have a couple of small lights on the exterior for security. Click the plus button to create new exterior lights. It automatically populates it with a load definition. Click the load definition, and we will say that total wattage is 400 watts for exterior lights. Next, go to schedule. The default schedule is set for always on. Discrete. If you wanted to edit this schedule, you can go to the Schedules tab and modify it. Next, we will look at the control option. Control option specifies that the lights go on based on the schedule only. Alternatively, you can select astronomical clock. Using this combines the two, so you will have a lighting schedule for the lights going on and off, and the astronomical clock will override that schedule if it's saying that the lights should be on during the daytime. Basically, the astronomical clock is a photocell that shuts the lights off during daylight hours. Next, you can do a multiplier, just like we have multipliers elsewhere, and this will multiply the wattage. And you have an end-use subcategory. The end-use subcategory is used for submetering. So if we wanted to have an additional electrical meter to track the energy use for the lights, we can rename this to General Ext Lights. And that is the Facility tab. Please like and subscribe. Thank you.